festivals, and theater arts in Asia.
Kai Luong. Kai Luong, classified as renovated theater or reformed theater, it is a mixture of Asian popular theater, Vietnamese folk music, and French comedy. This theater form from was first performed in the early 1900s.
Con, a masked, stylized dance drama with roots that can be traced back to the 16th century. This form of traditional theater evolved alongside the national epic story and the Thai version of Ramayana, which is the Ramakien. There is no dialogue in the con. Only a chorus tells the story on the side. A sophisticated and graceful art form that combines dance drama, the con features formalized movements, colored papier-mâché masks, and elaborate traditional costumes. It is considered a high art form that was originally performed to entertain the Thai royal family. Before, only men could stage the con because it was so strenuous. Today, female performers now take part in this theatrical art.
Nang Shadow Puppets. It was one form of public entertainment in the south of Thailand. It is still very popular at festivals, temple fairs, and celebrations such as marriages. They are delicately colored, but this does not show during a performance as the puppets appear only in shadow against a white sheet with light shining through from behind. They are manipulated with rods that control movements of the arms and legs, and usually performed during the country's dry season, February to August. Performances have a religious theme or have an episode from the Ramayana epic, which contains dozens of individual stories. They may also be specially written to include up-to-date minutes reflection songs and poems about local events and matters of current interest in the district or country. There are hundreds of different characters, each with distinctive shadow, but show will almost always include a clown, funny old man, scatterbrained old woman, or rather stupid yokel, who are all great favorites with the fun-loving audiences.
Lakon Basak. Lakon Basak, or Basak Opera, is one of the most popular folk theatrical forms in Cambodia. It is characterized by the larger-than-life and comic movements that depict specific scenes of early old Khmer literature, particularly the ones about the clash of good and evil spirits. This animated and amusing form of Khmer theater features dance, music, and melodrama, with performers appearing in extravagant costumes. Like other art forms, Lakon Basak nearly died during the oppressive Khmer Rouge period. The art has continued to thrive despite the murder of many of its performers.
Wayang Kulit. The Indonesian Wayang Kulit is one of the most well-known puppet theater arts in the world. Wayang refer to kinds of puppet theaters, sometimes itself is referred to as wayang. Kulit means skin, and refers to the leather construction of the puppets that are carefully shaped with very fine tools and supported with carefully shaped buffalo horn handles and control rods. Performances of shadow puppet theaters are accompanied by a gamelan orchestra in Java and by gender wayang in Bali. Wayang can be in form of wayang golek or rod puppets, wayang klitik or flat wood puppet, wayang orang or human puppets, and wayang hedog, masked human puppets.
Wayang kulit performance consists of shadows cast on a cotton screen and an oil lamp. The white screen symbolizes the universe where natives go on with their lives. The screen's brighter side is a representation of the material world, and the darkest side symbolizes the afterlife. The oil lamp, called the Blenkong, often takes the shape of the mythical bird Garuda. The lamp symbolizes the sun rays needed by all living things.
Zat Pue. Pue is a broad Burmese term for performances that encompass classical dance, drama, and musical opera. Zatpue is the most popular type of this performance. This highly stylized form combines dance, drama, and music to form an exceptional theater art. It is performed during the Pagoda Festival, featuring dancers, acrobats, and comedians accompanied by sainwang, which is a gong and percussion ensemble. Zatpue often adapts the stories of the Buddhist Jataka. Some performances of Zatpue also lift stories of Burmese history. Traditionally, it lasts the whole night.
Komedia. The komedia, sometimes called the moro-moro, is a form of theater art in our country, Philippines. This long play, which often lasts for 3 nights, tells the story of the religious and political conflicts between Christian and Muslim heroes. In the komedia, kings, princes, and dukes engage in intense battle, with the Christian always being triumphant in the end. The performers parade in magnificent costumes and props, and they dramatize the story using stylized acting. Komedia is often presented during festivals, gaining the patronage of the entire community.
Peking Opera. China is known for the traditional theater art form, the Peking Opera or Beijing Opera, which combines music, vocal performances, dance, and acrobatics. It started in the late 18th century and became fully developed and recognized by the mid-19th century. During the Qing Dynasty court, it became extremely popular and came to be regarded as one of the cultural treasures of China.
Kabuki. Kabuki is a form of traditional Japanese drama with highly stylized song, mime, and dance, now performed only by male actors, that evolved in Japan in the early 17th century. Kabuki theater is known for the stylization of its drama and for the elaborate makeup worn by some of its performers called kumadori. Kabuki is therefore sometimes translated as the art of singing and dancing. Since the word kabuki believed to be derived from the verb kabubu, meaning to lean or to be out of the ordinary, kabuki can be bizarre theater. The expression kabuki mono referred originally to those who were bizarrely dressed and paraded on the street.
No. No is Japan's oldest form of musical theater. The story is told not just through dialogue but also through other forms such as uta or singing, hayashi or musical accompaniment, and mai or dance. The no involves the use of slow movements, poetic language, monotonous tones, and rich and heavy costumes. Narratives are based on Japanese legends, history, literature, and contemporary events. The characters in a no are played by male performers. The characters play the shait, or the leading character, the waki, or the supporting character, the hayashi, or the musicians, the jutai, or the chorus, and the koken, or the stage attendants. One feature of no is that the leading actor, dressed in a colorful costume of embroidered silk, usually wears a lacquered wooden mask. The mask can depict characters such as an old man, a young or old woman, a divine figure, a ghost, and a young boy. The audience is also given sense of what character is being portrayed through mask.
Saang. The Saang is a form of folk dance drama performed especially in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, and Rajasthan in India. This folk dance drama incorporates theatrics and nakal or mimicry, which go with dialogues and songs. The Saang is more focused on dialogue than on gestures and movement. It is often draws materials from folk tales, Indian mythology, morality themes, and lives of inspiring figures. It also tackles themes such as literacy and education, health, and hygiene.
A group of 10 to 12 actors perform the Saang in an open-air theater where the stage is surrounded by the audience. Unlike in modern drama, the stage of Saang does not have ornate arrangements. There are no curtains and rooms or backstage areas where performers can change costumes or put on makeup. They perform only on a wooden platform. All they need is skill and stamina, as the performance often lasts up to 6 hours.
Loy Krathong. Loy literal meaning means to float, while Krathong refers to the lotus-shaped receptacle which can float on the water. Originally, the Krathong was made of banana leaves or the layer of the trunk of a banana tree or a spider lily plant. The festival is believed to originate in an ancient practice of paying respect to the spirit of water. The tradition is said to have begun in the 13th century when a young queen made a small boat adorned with candles and sent it down the river. It is a ritual honoring Fra May Kongka, the goddess of water. The construction of colorful boats was a way of not only giving thanks for the abundance of water, but also a way to seek forgiveness for overuse and pollution. The event takes place on the evening of the full moon of the 12th month in the traditional Thai lunar calendar, which falls on November in Western calendar. Waisak Festival. This is the most sacred day in Buddhism as it celebrates the birth of Buddha and his enlightenment as well as his attainment of Nirvana. This festival is celebrated in many Buddhist countries around the world, but the one in Borobudur in Java, Indonesia is perhaps the most remarkable. Borobudur, one of the region's most renowned cultural sites, has the largest Buddhist temple in the world. One of the highlights is the procession of monks from Mendut to Pawon and to Borobudur. Pilgrims light candles and offer flowers as the full moon rises, then they pray and chant.
Balinese Dance Festival. Balinese dances are a very ancient dance tradition that is a part of the religious and artistic expression among Balinese people. In Hinduism, dance is an accompaniment to the perpetual dissolving and reforming of the world. The creative and productive balance is often personified as Shiva's wife, Durga, sometimes called Uma, Parvati, or Kali. This has significance in Balinese Hinduism since the common figure of Rangla is similar in many ways to Durga. There are various categories of dance, including epic performances such as the Universal, Mahabharata, and Ramayana. The articulations in the face, eyes, hands, arms, hips, and feet are coordinated to reflect layers of percussive sounds.
Dragon Dance. Dragon dance is a form of traditional dance and performance in Chinese culture. It is the highlight of Chinese New Year celebration held worldwide in Chinatowns around the world. The dragon symbolizes power, strength, and good luck. The dance theme mimics the supposed movements of this river spirit in a flowing, rise and fall manner. The movements in performance traditionally symbolize historical roles of dragons, demonstrating power and dignity. Dragons are believed to bring good luck to people, which are reflected in their qualities that include great power, dignity, fertility, wisdom, and prosperity.
Kodo Taiko Drum Festival. The taiko is considered one of the most primitive of all Japanese musical instruments. It is thought to have used in communication and religious rituals in Japan. The taiko was used in feudal Japan for motivating troops and calling out orders or announcements. It was also used as an accompaniment for marching. The taiko is commonly found at Shinto shrines and Buddhist temples. It is used in religious ceremonies and local festivals. Priests authorize Japanese men to play the taiko during special occasion. Taiko drumming has been popularized by a professional group called the Kodo. The group is based in Sado, Japan, and managed to introduce taiko drumming in other places abroad. The word Kodo conveys two meanings: heartbeat, the primal source of all rhythm, and read in different way, children of the drum, a reflection of Kodo's desire to play the drum simply with the heart of the children.
Holi. Holi, also known as the Festival of Colors, is a two-day Indian festival that celebrates not only the triumph of good, Prince Prahlad, over evil, Holika, but also the richness of the harvest that comes with spring. On the eve of the festival, revelers sing and dance around Holika bonfires. On the day of the festival, they gather in public areas and throw wet and dry colors of different hues to one another. Some use water guns, and others throw balloons filled with colored water. Passover. The Passover is a very important Jewish festival. Passover is observed from the 15th to the 22nd of the Hebrew month of Nisan. The Passover is a very important Jewish festival. It is a way for Jews to commemorate the liberation of Israelites from slavery in Egypt. The first 2 days and last two of Passover are full-fledged holidays. On the first two nights, Jews eat the Seder, which is composed of lamps with bitter herbs and unreasoned bread without yeast. They light holiday candles at night, perform the Kiddush, or a ceremony of word and wine, and enjoy lavish holiday meals on both night and day. The middle days, known as Hol Hamoed, are semi-festive days when some Jews are allowed to work.